Hello everyone, this is Amit Dhan of AmitDhan.com. Today I'll have another episode of work video, and on this channel I'm always trying new and different ideas. If that is something you're interested in, please visit for more. If you're only interested in work videos, there will be links in the description box below. So I just passed the corner of Bathurst and Richmond, and we are walking along Richmond Street today. So nothing planned. I'll see how far I can go, and along the way we'll cut through downtown Toronto. So right now we are in downtown Toronto, and the temperature is at -10. There's a little bit wind, which makes it feel slightly colder than -10. And if I sound a little bit not clear, it's due to the fact that I'm wearing a mask, and you know, it's kind of blocking my voice. So it's a beautiful day. The sun is out, unless not too brightly sunny. I see there's a construction right here. So this part of Richmond Street is a little bit quiet, but when we move farther east, then it's going to be busier. Although due to COVID, you may not see, you know, lots of people or stores open, but still it's a nice walk. And here is CN Tower. This is the corner of Corktown Street and Richmond Street West. This is in Fashion District. So this is not a too big street, it's a narrow street. Some old buildings on both sides, and also constructions of some new condos. So the wall of this building looks a little bit unique. And you can see some very old houses. So I'm not wearing gloves, but I can feel the fingers are freezing. So at this point, at one point, I may have to wear my gloves back. More construction. We have a small street here, and that's the entrance to the graffiti alley, which I have showed you in my past Queen Street Walk video. So I'm going to just switch my hand, and I'm going to wear my gloves on my right hand because, you know, it's getting too cold. You might feel a little bit shake. So Brant Street. And here is the other side of Brant Street. Okay, so looks like we cannot walk on this side of the street, so I'm going to just wait for the signal to cross. And you can see they're building some buildings. Just wait a few seconds for the light to turn walk. Okay, well, it looks like we have an opportunity to cross, and this is a one-way street. I can see a big crane. So as you can see, the streets are not crowded. I see some people here and there, but looks like this guy is still working. And the huge crane is operating. So let's take a close look at the queen. So I think I scared the police officer a little bit. I said hello officer, and he was kind of a little bit shocked. The street coming up should be Spadina. And it's kind of curved this way. Have a quick look at Spadina while I wait for the traffic. As you can see, the street curves. And this is Chinatown. But if you walk a little bit north, then you're going to be right in the middle of Chinatown. But it's not that crowded due to COVID. Usually this place is very crowded at this time, or most of the time, but not today. So we have the walk sign. Looks like the birds are having a party there. The guy looks like feeding them, and lots of the pigeons. There's some nice stores here, but all of them are closed. And on my right, there is a gallery. It looks like a very old building. And you can see on top. So if you're in downtown Toronto, this is what you'll see, a mixture of old and new buildings. They coexist side by side. If you look front, there's a nice looking red and white building coming up. I'll try to show it closer once we are there. That looks like a newer building with very nice color. Can't see any street sign yet. So we are in Entertainment District, and this is actually Peter Street. And let me just show you a bit. So there's a police box right here, although I'm not sure what is the purpose of this, if they're monitoring or there's some sort of help feature, but let's take a look here. I don't see any camera, so not exactly sure. So let's continue. And we are close to the red and white building, so I'll take some closer pictures. So here we have a restaurant, but you know, due to COVID, they're all closed. But they have a nice patio here, good for summer. Here I see some columns, but not sure if this is art or supporting the building. But definitely look good. So here we are in front of the black, the white and red building, which is 318 Richmond Street. That's the address, but definitely it has unique designing and looks really good. And I can see on top some of the unit owners have actually open patio. And here is the glimpse of the columns right here. So this looks good too. So let's continue. There's another police box. Actually, we have a better view of the black and red building, so let's take a look. Very quiet. So we have a theater here, but they're all closed, and this is the Scotiabank theater. I've been here many times before. And let me just take a... Actually, I have to cross the street to show you a better view. But this one has very unique designing too. So let me just see how it looks here. And if I get an opportunity, I'll cross the street. But before I do that, let me look at the red and white building again. You can see other side from this angle, and let me just cross the street. There's no car coming in, so I can show you the Scotia Theatre. So here's the Scotia Theatre, which happened to be also an IMAX theatre, but everything is closed right now. And this is John Street. So let me show you the other side of John Street. Stop here a little bit and see if I can bring the Scotia building or Scotia theater and the white building together, but I think for that I have to cross the street again. So this looks really good from here. Just cross right now, and here is an opportunity to catch both of them together. So very nice view. I'll see how it looks. I might put this on my thumbnail if it looks okay when I do the editing. And we have a nice view of the CN Tower on our right. I see lots of empty benches. Not sure what's the purpose. It looks like they're probably open restaurant or open market. Another view of CN Tower. Duncan Street. And it looks like this is the Sham radio station and iHeart radio. So if you listen radio, then looks like this is their station. Feels a little bit colder now. Wind is getting slightly stronger. So here, I believe they show international stand-up comedy. Probably nothing going on now. Twilight Lane, and the street coming up is Simcoe Street. There's a Tim Hortons on the corner. And then we have University Avenue. Let's look at the other side of Simcoe. And here's the old Canada Life building. So let's cross the street. So University Avenue is coming up. And actually this avenue kind of reminds me of Park Avenue in New York. So let's have a quick look at the University Avenue on both sides. some sort of demonstration. Not sure what is this. Box sign is on. We have 9 seconds, so let's make it fast. So another glimpse of university. The red van you're looking at, this is kind of post mail delivery. Hilton Hotel, looks like the building is very old, but if you go inside probably you're not going to feel anything that this is an old building. And Sheraton Hotels, same thing, the building is old. And here's the full Sheraton building. York Street. This is the other side of York Street. So I see that this is 111 Richmond St West, so it looks like we are going to go into the Richmond St East very shortly. I see the bay, so we should be close to Yonge Street. Street. Bay Street coming up. Street on our left. This is the old city building. Ad of Columbia jacket looks very cool. Some bay across the street here. So it looks like this is curbside pickup. This is a place to online orders, and then you know you can pick up without going to the store. Yonge Street. So we are going to Richmond Street East. Right now this is Richmond Street West. So this building, 151 Yonge Street, used to be my work building many years before, probably 10-15 years before. This is where I worked. So let's have it. So let's cross the street and we're going to have a look at Yonge Street. So here's the other side of Yonge Street. Continue. My nose tip seems to be freezing, but it's still manageable. Victoria Street. Side of Victoria Street. And let's just look at the other side. On Richmond, so you can notice that there are not many buildings this side. There are smaller buildings, so most big skyscrapers and big buildings are on the other side. Street, a rather small street. Queen Street on the left. You can see that this is Richmond Street East now, because we passed Yonge Street, which divides East and West streets. So you have Church Street right here. Take a look at the other side. So there's a Henry camera store right here, where I came before to buy cameras, and I believe I came here more than one time. I see a big curb coming up, so it could be the street is merging. Let's take a look. I was expecting to be warmer than this, but looks like it's not that warm I was hoping for. So you have a Petro Canada gas station, and the green covering, you can see this is for bike. So this is bike lane. So I'm not sure I have to go to the right or straight. I have a feeling I have to stay on the right. So I'll just stay here and see if this is the right way. But I can see this is Richmond Street here. So let's see how it goes here. And this is Jarvis Street. So we're going to cross. Yes, actually Richmond Street continues from here. You can see the sign. So just take it from here. And you can see some nice stores here. And you can see the sign at Richmond Street. So this muffin store is open. World's best apple cake must be legal eating for a slice. Never convicted. So the store has some unique writings on here. And let's take a look around. So this is the cross section of Richmond and Jarvis. And you can see some nice graffiti or artwork on the wall right at the Petro Canada gas station. So we'll continue. This part is even getting quieter. Not many people or buildings. George Street coming up. So looks like we have some art gallery here. And on Richmond Street there are lots of art galleries here and there. And you can see a diner, George Street Diner. Probably it's no longer operational, but I kind of miss a diner old way. You don't see them that many these days. So here, George Brown College. So it has to be one of their campuses. They have several campuses across Toronto. A few more galleries. So the name of the street is Stonecutters Inn. Oh, sorry, Stonecutters Lane, not Inn. And these condos seem to be old. Looks old. Sherbourne Street. Tim Hortons on the corner. And let's have a quick look. The other side of Sherbourne. Very quiet neighborhood. And some very old buildings here and there. I have a feeling the end of Richmond Street is very close. But let's see how far it goes. Ontario Street coming up. So my trips are not planned. I know that I'm going to take this street, but I didn't really plan how far I was going to walk or where to stop, where not to stop. So everything is spontaneous. And this way you get to see the real thing. And definitely when I go and travel, possibly this year, you're going to see more of walking videos from other countries. I've been to many countries, but that time I didn't make any walk videos. So now I kind of like, you know, regret not having walk videos in places like Melbourne, Auckland, Kuala Lumpur, Singapore, Sydney, and many other places on earth. But definitely in the future, wherever I go, you're gonna see a walk video from that place. Street. Parliament Street, and it doesn't look like Richmond Street is going beyond this point, or even if it does, then I cannot walk because there's no walking path. So this is Parliament Street. And I'm just going to walk up to another block. Which looks like Queen Street. And I'm going to end my video on this corner, Queen and Parliament. So we're looking at another 2-3 minutes of video. And on this channel, you'll find a variety of videos. I'm always trying new and different ideas. So if you're interested, come back for more. But if you're only interested in vlog videos, there'll be links in the description box below. So let's take a look at Queen Street. So here's for staying this long. There'll be more videos coming up, so I'll see you shortly. Thank you.